What's up, Rocksters and Lambs? It's Josh Cooley coming to you from Studio J-Bright. I thought I would take the moment to actually reflect a little bit this week. I've had a lot of domestic time. Like, when I don't have an event to go to, or I just want to stay home, I sometimes stay home and I attempt to clean, I attempt to cook. I'm a much better cooker than I am a housekeeper. That's why I have a housekeeper and not a cook. Anyway, I wanted to say thank you guys so much for the relaunch of Inside Studio J-Rai. It was formerly Pretty World Fabulous Life. I have to tell you that the ratings for Inside Studio J-Rai are much higher and much more well-received than a memoir-style tell-all blog. I think I'm a little over the tell-all. I do like tell-all in a video, though. I think it's pretty fun. So, you know, I talked about kindness, and it was kind of cool because if you go to studiojrai.blogspot.com, we've talked about kindness, friendship, betrayal. Friendship, I love the subject of friendship. Betrayal is not one of my favorites because I didn't want to call anyone out, but I want to reflect a little bit on kindness. And it's so funny because you'll have to read the piece, but there were a couple people when I was reading the piece, and you can go there. It's so funny that I called out on Facebook, you know. I want to thank Goon for giving us the subject. She's a really, really sweet girl that I've gotten to know. We were at a Christmas party this last weekend together. It was wonderful, and I was also with Felicia and Arlene. Felicia is a bartender at the Watering Hole I frequent, the downtown bar in Pueblo, Colorado. You can find them on Twitter at the Downtown Bar. And you can get, just search them on the internet, the Downtown Bar, Pueblo, Colorado. They are the place to be. I have to tell you that. They are the coolest people. Brian and Keith are very good friends of mine. But, you know, I was thinking about kindness and Feely is what we call her. You know, Feely hadn't known me very long, when she started bartending. And I had one of those nights, we all have them, I'm very naked in this anecdote, but one of those nights where I drank way too much and drank all my feelings. Some people eat their feelings. I do that too. But I drank all my feelings that night and was kind of upset and attempted to walk home. I had no idea of this circumstance. I'm not proud of those moments. I'm never proud when somebody tells me an inebriated story. I feel like Brandy on The Housewives of Beverly Hills when somebody tells me that I did stuff like this. But she stopped and she gave me a ride, and she didn't really know me very well. It's not like we've been friends for years. It's not like we went to school together. It's not like we're best mates, nothing like that. But she stopped and gave me a ride. And, you know, I have to tell you, for somebody who didn't know me, she did the right thing. She's a truly kind individual. And my piece really reminded me of her, somebody who has no ulterior motive, that is not trying to win your love or try to do anything to make herself look better. She just already is that person. The other person that I pointed out was Arlene, and Arlene is a person that, if you go back in some of my video blogs, I've talked about her. She owns Sheer Results in Pueblo, Colorado. It is by far one of the most amazing places you could go to get your hair done. The top retailer in the entire county, as far as I'm concerned. She's wonderful. She's a good mentor to me and a good friend to me, and we do business together, and I love that she has a very non-threatening way. And to me, when you're non-threatening and you're welcoming, you want people to do well, you yourself are the epitome of compassion and kindness. I think both of those individuals are really fucking amazing, if you ask me, in my own colorful way of giving you a compliment. You're just fucking amazing, both of you are. But the feedback that I got was, of course, from Philly and Arlene. And I have to tell you, because I'm reading it right now on my phone, but like, you know, if you ever read any of my pieces, I always take an analogy. I try to relate it to something in popular culture. I made the example of Samantha from Sex and the City being, I think, the kindest of all the girls. She was a slut, but she was the kindest. If you remember the episode when Carrie cheats on Aiden, everybody's favorite, with Big, who was my favorite, and she tells the girls one night when they're watching An Affair to Remember, I believe it was season 3 or 4, I want to say it's the end of season 3 or beginning of season 4. And she cheats. And she tells Samantha when they're doing dishes together, she says, "I slept with Big." And she goes, "Was it good?" And she's just being a friend, you know. And she goes, long story short, to Samantha and asks her, "Don't you want to judge me just a little bit?" And Samantha tells her, "It's not my style, wink." And you know, for me, even Samantha in the movie, in Sex and the City, the original movie that came out in, I think, 2008, you know, when she feeds Carrie after Big leaves her at the altar, you know, Samantha was the kindest, most amazing friend, always. And, you know, I've always been called, you know, told from friends, multiple friends now, that I'm Carrie with Samantha's mouth. I just don't give a fuck, dude, like, ever. But I'm always wondering and a little bit naive at times. So, I love that. You know, Arlene, you know, one of her messages was that she wishes me nothing but the best for 2014. And that's the relationship that we have. So, you know, I want to thank you guys so much for visiting that. If you want to check out Kindness, it is volume 1.3, J. Rye Takes on Kindness, and you can find that at studiojrye.blogspot.com. Just a couple little shout-outs. I just want to thank my boy Michael Hartkopf at Solar Roast Coffee. You can find them on Twitter at Solar Roast. They're the best coffee house in town, just telling you, and a really amazing menu. And I want to thank everybody that really contributed to our toy drive, the Father Christmas toy drive number 2. We did really well. I'm still getting donations, and I'm going to have to like privately deliver them tomorrow or Saturday or something, but keep them coming. I will get them to CASA or YWCA as soon as I can. It has to happen before Christmas, obviously. Father Christmas works at all hours before then, so thank you to everybody. I just am so proud and so happy of all my friends, and I'm so happy for this blog, and you know, as many shout-outs as I wish I could possibly give, I can't. You can find my my gift guide on rockstarslums.blogspot.com. Shout-out to Emily and her brand, Emily and Tony. It's an adult brand. I think they're a great couple's gift. You should check them out at emilyandtony.com. And, of course, you can always find me at josh-cooley.com. Thanks for reading, and I look forward to doing a video again soon. Love you all. Mwah. Happy Christmas.